and have fun. And, he was just like kind of stick up his ass, basically. You didn't treat to me how you should have, motherfucker. Thank you for being here. My name is Kyra, and today we're reacting to Miley Cyrus's new single called Flowers. I've heard the chorus. I haven't really heard the verses. The first reason I like heard of the song was because Twitter went insane and there was a thread about secret hidden Easter eggs and stuff. And then her sister, I guess, came out and said the theories are funny. So she still doesn't answer if they're correct, though. I'm assuming she thinks they're not correct. We're going to talk about it at the end of the video. But apparently, a lot of things are going on when it comes to Liam Hemsworth and her ex-husband. Now, she said a long time ago that he didn't cheat on her. But, you know, I feel like some people think otherwise, me included, because... You know that whole Jennifer Lawrence kiss back when they filmed The Hunger Games off screen, may I add? We're gonna talk about all that at the end of the video. Make sure to let me know what you think about all the drama down below. Don't forget to give it a like and subscribe and help a girl out, because I really appreciate it if you want to see more content like this in the future. Oh my god, 116 million? Fuck. See, I knew it was popping, but damn, bitch. Holy fuck, okay.
We were good, we were gold. Kind of dream that can't be sold. We were right till we learned. Built a home and watched it burn.
Now this, I did see in that thread. I guess we're going to talk about what I seen in the Twitter threads throughout the music video. The line, you know, she's talking about Liam, obviously. But then the end, really traumatic, because their house, and I believe it was Malibu, burnt down. And they lost completely everything. There was like so many wildfires. Y'all remember that shit? We don't get that shit in Michigan.
I didn't wanna leave you. I didn't wanna lie. Started to cry, but then remembered I can buy myself flowers. Write my name in the sand. Talk to myself for hours. See things you don't understand.
She's so pretty. Talk about how gorgeous she looks right now. Obviously, she's being very open and vulnerable, talking about how she didn't want to leave, but at the same time, like, bitch, I had to, because you didn't treat to me how you should have, motherfucker. And while she was just singing that last little bit, what came to mind was the red carpet incident. I've been seeing that all over YouTube and Twitter too, where where she was dancing on the red carpet, right? And he was like, nah, don't be doing all that, you're doing too much. You're just trying to be innocent, have fun, and he was just like kind of stick up his ass, basically.
But then remembered I can buy myself flowers.
Oh, she's getting into it. Oh my god. This part that came up in the Twitter thread, apparently she's wearing like the same version. Oh yeah, the same version of tux, or like a similar tux that he was wearing on the red carpet where he was acting crazy. I love that Miley's having a resurgence right now. She did not come here to play. I see why this video blew the fuck up. She delivered. She did not disappoint at all. I already loved the meaning of it beforehand because, you know, obviously the self-love aspect and how they were together for like a decade. And after all that time, she still didn't really speak up, and that's why all the speculation is going on the internet. Oh my god, it's number one around the world. Oh, I did see something online too that said this was her first Billboard number one debut in like 17 years. What, since like Hannah Montana? Like, what the fuck? Okay, so this is just one tweet. Miley Cyrus releasing flowers on Liam Hemsworth's birthday, mirroring the song he dedicated her, which is When I Was Your Man by Bruno Mars. Who's Bruno Smith? And filming a music video in the house he had 14 plus affairs in. I love. Okay, so the 14 plus affairs thing, I need some tea on, because I looked on like Google and what I was seeing was not that. I was just seeing speculation, but I haven't seen like anyone really come out from her side. Aww. On 2013, she said on Wrecking Ball that she was never going to be able to forget him the day she puts herself first. Fuck yeah, that's awesome. What do you guys think of the drama? Do you guys think that he actually cheated on her? I would like to say yes, but I feel like, yeah, because, like, y'all know the Jennifer Lawrence thing where, like, they kissed off scene when it came to the Hunger Games? She admitted it, so I don't know if they were on or off at that time, but regardless, it's a little fishy. It's a little fishy. So yeah, let me know what you think of the music video and what you think of everything going on surrounding the music video. Let me know what your favorite part was and your favorite Easter egg in the music video. Make sure to give it a like and subscribe if you enjoy the content, because I'll be posting more soon. Sam Smith's album coming up in like 15 minutes and I'm so excited. So yeah, I'm gonna film that next. But let me know what you think of this video down below. I hope you enjoyed it and I hope to see you in my next video. Bye! That bitch is crazy. Y'all gonna have some ugly ass babies.